Hello. 3 videos ago, I decided to build a lathe. The reason why I decided to build a lathe is because I needed a few columns for the house. I therefore changed a chainsaw into a lathe. I since posted the video, even though I posted it 12 years later. The reaction that I got were mostly negative. More negative thumbs down than positive thumbs up. Therefore, I decided to build a lathe. I have no knowledge, I have no training using a lathe. So as far as I'm concerned, if I show you that I built a lathe and have it spin, for the record, I'm not starting with a small piece of wood. I'm starting with an 8-foot long piece of lumber, 4x4. When I was using the chainsaw, I was using a 6x6 beam. With the chainsaw, I felt like I was fully in control, which is not the case right now. The motor has control of the speed. I have 2 different pulleys. The whole thing is the new pulley that I built. Lumber is sold in standard sizes. So I built the pulley based on the available lumber. Okay, there is noise going on now, so I'll stop talking and come back and show you a few details of the installation. So as far as I'm concerned, if I give it a spin and it's spinning, I have proof, you have proof that it was done. And I think it was well done. There were other parts that I had planned to include, a rest for the tool, etc. But I realized that will take more time, which I don't have. The sun is not always at the right angle, and I like to show my videos at a certain angle in the sun. So I'll be right back and show you what's going on and give you the spin test. And I'll even try to chew some wood, but with no training, whatever I chew, if I make a section round, that will be good enough, I hope. Thank you. Bye bye. This is today's setup. I have 2 pulleys that I made. And if you have watched my other 2 videos entitled Outdoors Lathe Parts and Outdoors Lathe Setup, you should be familiar with the setup. There is a long bolt that goes from the post and travels at least 4 inches inside the beam with washers between the beam and the post. I have a motor and a flat belt that's not perfect, but it's a recycled belt with a curve in it at some point, but it's turning it fine from what I can tell. And this is 8 foot long, and it goes all the way to the other post. And in the other post at the bottom of it, you can see a few belts. I didn't know what size belt I was going to use. So basically, you have to install the pulleys before you hang the square beam, and you also have to have the belts in there. I'm going to use 1 beam there because I think that's enough speed for this one. My understanding is that the smaller the radius of the piece you're turning, the faster the speed has to be. Since I did not trust the power that I'm playing with, I installed a post there just in case something goes wrong. I don't want the beam to travel towards me, so I attach it to a rope and it goes up there. And I have a metal post and some hard piece of wire
that's attached to the top of the post to give me some kind of security. Alright, so that's the basic setup, like I said, and pretty soon I'll make it spin. There's a big trash truck making noise in the background, but what do you expect? It's Monday morning and the city comes to its noisy life. The dog is not barking, that's a good thing. So I'll detach the camera right now and take a closer look at everything. Here are the basic facts. I dug a couple of holes in the ground, buried that post at least a foot and a half, maybe more, and also braced it with another piece that's screwed on my top of my wall there. Like that, I won't have any motion back and forth. The flat side, I really wedged it left and right with rocks, so I'm not worried about the beam wouldn't let the thing collapse either way, so that I'm not worrying about it traveling backwards either. Then I installed my pulleys. This is the first pulley that I made. I made a second one with a wider diameter or radius, whichever you prefer. And here's my safety post here. I hope it's enough, but I don't feel in control. That's why this is there. I am not familiar with speed of rotation, and that thing is rotating pretty fast. Here I have the other post and my belts, and there's a lot of noise. In the middle I put another post. That's where I'm going to rest one of my improvised tool and hopefully chew some wood. I watch a few videos on YouTube and everybody have their techniques. I watch people spinning the beam by foot with a rope that makes one turn around the beam in Morocco and different countries. So here I have a motor that's in charge, so we are all going to get ready to power this baby and you can watch it spin yourself. Hold on. Talk. All right, it's showtime. Here's my plug. I'm plugging it. Here goes nothing. As a matter of fact, nothing went. I had the beam, the safety beam, leaning against the pole. Let's try that again. And it's spinning. I let it spin for a while. And I even tried to cut. But it's done. This is the slow speed. I don't know if it's at the exact speed it's supposed to be. But here I have my cutting edge here. I'll try to chew some wood. think I can give you a little close up on the action right now. Here we go. So you're not watching this to learn how to use a lathe. Can't help you there. You watch it to learn how to make. Okay, plug it to see how we did. It's not even round yet. So I think my tools are a little dull, so I'll sharpen the tool a little bit. I can do a little more, so I'll keep rolling. Why not? As long as it's rolling, just checking. All right, here we go again.